ovog materijala. And it has this state. This and this subject taught in the machine design class. Machine design class. But in the United States and in Japan, these subjects are taught in the class separately, independently of machine design. I think this is very important to you. All these subjects contain very important concept. And if we this subject taught in the course of machine design, the very important concept cannot be captured by the student very clearly. Maybe the machine design in the student maybe have good motivation if these subject is included in this course. But even though we have very important concept in this subject, so I start from the stress. Concept of stress and concept of stress field. This is independent of the property of stress. Stress is independent of strain and deformation. It comes from independent the principle. And you may think that we already learned stress. And in Japan, it's the same. Students we learned stress in the course of strength of material, and Costa said, we already taught and we already understand stress. But even the university students do not understand some important concept of stress. So I start from this concept of stress. That's the first figure. Figure one showed the solid and you may imagine a rock in a deep sea, and this rock is subject to the hydraulic pressure P. Okay? And what is the stress state in this rock? Sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, or tau x y, or something like this. How do you determine this stress state in this rock? It is a little tricky problem. Maybe in the end of this chapter, you will understand how to determine the stress state in this. This is simple, but a little bit tricky problem. First, we start from the surface condition. This is here. Here, we know the pressure act on the surface of rock in the normal direction, perpendicular to the surface. You are leaving this. But why, you know, that this pressure acting, you know, in the normal direction? Why, you know, the pressure does not act in the inclined direction? What is the reason? Can someone explain why, you know, pressure is perpendicular to the surface?
The global equilibrium.
I can see here.
I think that's the equilibrium, the global equilibrium of the rock.
global equilibrium rock.
Static condition.
Even if you know the pressure act in the blank way, rock can stay in a static stable condition if the old surface external force, all the external force in the equilibrium condition. If you have definition is acting in a different way in the, this is, you know, the this comes from the difference from the property of the solid and liquid. And here at the surface we have to consider the principle of action and reaction. Okay? Action and reaction. Here, you know, in rock can sustain the force in any direction, for the normal force or some conventional force. Rock can sustain this. But from the viewpoint of action and reaction, same force act, in this case, same form act to the liquid. And the liquid can sustain the normal force, okay? But liquid cannot sustain in the shear force acting in the opposite direction. This is the liquid, okay? So the difference of the solid and liquid is liquid cannot sustain the shear stress in a static condition. This is the difference of the solid and liquid. So the rock can sustain the force in any direction, but the liquid cannot sustain. That's from the principle of action and reaction. This never occurs, you know. This condition never exists. So that we have always in liquid or in high pressure gas, surface of the solid is always subject to the normal force. Okay, this is the liquid. And first thing inside the rock, you know, we shall study later. And this is the normal stress. We start from the stress condition at the surface because we don't know the stress condition inside the solid. And also the shearing stress, we start from the surface shear stress. Shear stress or shearing stress. Here, if we try to move this block on the table, we have a frictional force here. This the frictional force is very classical equation. Frictional force is frictional coefficient and the weight of this block. And at the surface of the table or bottom surface of block, we have the shear average shear stress of F over A. Yes, you know? This is the shear stress we know on the surface. Inside the block or in the table, we don't know the shear stress distribution. And next we go into the stress inside the solid. We don't know the the stress rate inside the solid, but first we start from the definition of stress. like this. This, we assume a small area A, and probably here we have a force acting in the normal direction, and also the acting in the tangential direction with T. This is the tangential direction. If we assume a small infinitesimal area, and this is average normal stress at delta A, and by taking a limit of this expression, we have a definition of normal stress and the tangential stress, and we say this is a stress at point. This is a little bit ambiguous, strange expression. Stress at point. You know, this is point means stress is always defined by the force per unit area. By unit area, always, you know, we assume the some, imagine some area acting force. But sometimes we say the stress at this point, you know. So you must not misunderstand, you know, the stress acting at the point, you know. Point stress acting at point is just mean that in the limiting expression, not at point, you know. So the always we say megapascal or kilogram force, square meter. That means define the quantity by unit area and say. Usually say, you know, that this stress at point. Here, think about the rock in the deep sea, but this is a little bit of a difficult problem. So we start from the plate with the arbitrary shape. You know, at the boundary, we have pressure here. This is a two-dimensional problem. What is the stress state at point A? I say point A. That means maybe sigma x, sigma y, tau x. What are these values? Oh, this is the arbitrary shape is. It's tricky, you know. It is very difficult to challenge, you know, the arbitrary problem. Arbitrary means the shape is not well defined. So, I, many years ago, more than 20 years ago, I gave this problem in the examination of our university, and more than almost 300 students challenged this problem, and I got no correct answer, and no solution is given in the elasticity book in the world. You can't find the solution of this problem in the elasticity book. But now you can solve this. This is the arbitrary shape. Very ambiguous. So we give up to solve the arbitrary problem at first. We always start from the simple problem we know. Always, when we challenge the very difficult problem, we start from the basic simple problem. This is very important. And in case of simple problem, you have some definite equation principle, and on the basis of this knowledge, we start. So this is very simple problem, rectangular plate, yeah? And subject to the tensile stress, sigma x naught in the x direction and sigma y naught in the y direction. And here we have the inside E, at point E, we have sigma x equal to this value, sigma y equal to this value, and tau x y equals 0. And in case of the shear stress, is at the boundary, we have in the case of the rectangular plate, and this figure, we must imagine the sum of this rectangular plate has this thickness and the shear stress is acting in this side wall, okay? Here, okay, this way. And if the, we have the shear stress in this direction, the same shear stress must exist in this bottom surface because it is from viewpoint of equilibrium condition. Equilibrium condition. Also, when we, if we have a shear stress in this direction, we have this shear stress, same quantity in the opposite direction from viewpoint of equilibrium condition. But this is not complete from the viewpoint point of equilibrium condition, because this, if we don't have this shear stress, the stress equilibrium condition in x direction is okay, but this plate has the rotation, okay, this way, rotation. So that to avoid this rotation, shear stress must satisfy the equilibrium condition of rotation. This is here. You know, BC means the length of this. We assume the thickness of plate is 1 unit. So the BC times tau xy node, it is a force in this direction. And AB is this arm of. We take the rotation of the A axis through the A, this B, the rotation around the axis A. So this is the rotation of this direction here. And this is the rotation in the opposite direction from CD tau XY, tau YX node, and DA is the distance. Here the tau xy, no, tau xy means shear stress acting plane x equal constant, and this is the direction. This is the direction. Here we know the tau yx mode. This is the plane acting plane, okay, y equal constant. Acting on the plane y equals constant, and this is the direction acting. So this is this, in case of shear stress, so we always like that some suffix like how x y something or how c end up like this. And this is for shear expressing shear stress. This is suffix is important. Anyway, from rotation condition, equilibrium rotation, and here this BC equal DA, AB equal CD, that means that tau xy 0 equal tau yx, tau xy naught is tau yx naught. So this is a very, very important condition and property in the stress. Later I give you some exercise to remember this. Very often you know, engineer forget this importance of the, this rule. This is very important. So you may know the already know, but I think you may not understand the importance of this rule very well. So it means this rule means when we have tau here, we have this and this, 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 all this pair. And the direction is opposite, we have opposite like this, this is it. And the shear stress always exists in this room. Let me see. In this, it means this never exists. Okay? This never exists. Because this is, we don't have here. Okay? This never uses. Okay? And when we take the different coordinate, shear stress always have this loop over to this. Always shear stress exists only in this set. Okay? I mean the set means this, all this set. This never exists. In some textbooks of strengths of materials, we see the many figures like this in the textbook. But this never exists. Never exists. So this is a very important rule. And in my lecture, probably only the about less than 10 important rules. This is the first one. And this, the second one is this stress transformation. This stress transformation is in the plate, we have, in the remote stress, we have all stress components sigma x, sigma y, tau x, and we want to know the stress in the different, acting in the different plane, like BC. And I believe you already know this. This is stress transformation is given by the equilibrium condition of this triangular element. We use only the equilibrium condition. So now the force acting in this direction is in the equilibrium condition in this and in this direction. So I skip the detailed equation. Let me see. Okay. Let's try to solve the. This is the, and please mark, you know, this is the second important rule. First important rule in my lecture is tau, shear stress always exists in the set. Okay? Tau x, y equals tau y x, or tau any other coordinate. Tau x, y equals tau y x, tau theta, eta. Always used in the set. This is the first rule, important. Second is the stress transformation, this equation in 2D program, okay? So this is, assume we have this stress, this stress in the XY coordinate. And we want to know the, this is the XY, we want to know the another direction, see? This is have the direction degrees theta in x direction. So this is sigma c is sigma x cosine squares theta sigma y sine square plus 2xy tau xy sine theta times theta. My students very often make mistakes like this. Sigma C and sigma X, sigma cosine T. Yes. Very often use that this is not, this is the square is correct answer. Because the students think that the sigma X is in this direction. So this cosine theta is this, it's okay. But from the beginning, as I explained you, the stress in the force per unit area. This is not force itself. If this is a force itself, you may take the component of vector. You may just, you know, something like peak C is the x cosine. This is okay, but if it is a force, but it is stress. So you must use this. You don't memorize this equation, but you must use this equation. Okay, very important. And this is I already two important rules. This is the third important rule we can. Now we want to find the stress rate inside this arbitrary plate subjecting pressure at the boundary. How do we solve this problem? This is the we have to solve the problem of arbitrary plate. So we start from the rectangular plate. This rectangular plate. And this is x, y. In this simple problem, we know that stress inside the plate is sigma x equal minus p, sigma y equal minus p, tau x y equal 0. Okay? This is obvious. Okay? And we imagine as the shape of this boundary. Just imagine inside this rectangular plate, the same shape. Okay? And this we imagine, and we calibrate the stress at this point. X, C, theta, and if we calculate sigma C at this point, inside this rectangular plate, sigma X cosine square theta plus sigma Y sine square theta plus out plus 2 tau x y cosine theta times theta. This is I write here, and this is 0. This is minus p. This is minus p. Minus p cosine square plus sine square theta equals minus p. Okay. So at this boundary. This is not a special point, not a particular point. So at all these boundaries, we have sigma C or minus P. Okay? And if we calculate tau C even, it is shear stress at this direction. Here, I calculate here sigma minus sigma x cosine theta sine theta. And this is zero. It means all this imagined along the imagined boundary, we have minus p here in the normal direction, and shear stress is zero. This is a completely stress condition that this imagined shape completely shaped the same that this arbitrary frame. Okay? Do you agree with this? Okay? So the instead of calculating the stress in the point A in this arbitrary shape plate, we may calculate the stress at point A in the rectangular plate. Okay? We calculate the stress here. And it's already we have finished. This is in direction of C. The same, we can apply the same calculation here. So that everywhere inside of this imagined shape plate, we have sigma. So the sigma here, everywhere sigma c or minus p sigma eta equals minus p tau c eta equals zero. Okay? So the solution of this problem is, this problem is we have the arbitrary shaped plate as in subjecting the pressure. Maybe it may be a tensile, uniform tensile so the pressure here. And inside is, and everywhere in every direction, we have the compressive stress minus P and no shear stress inside here. This is very useful solution when you think about the more advanced problem. So remember this, this problem will appear in the later section. Okay? This is a fairly important rule in my lectures. Okay? Any question? If you have any question to ask in when I am talking, okay? So this started three-dimensional stress rate. Okay, this is a calculation of the stress transformation of three-dimensional. Yes, I think you have already learned in some way or another. It's this is instead of sine and cosine parameter here, we express sigma c in direction of z axis in terms of this direction sign. Direction sign means cosine among these two axes. Okay? This is all the cosine. For example, m1 means the cosine of the angle between the y-axis and c-axis. Okay? So you can write this. Anyway, so next is the principal stress. Okay? And usually the in the strength of materials, or even in the theory of elasticity, principal stress is calculated from this equation. From this equation, by differentiating sigma c and theta and finding finding a maximum minimum body weight. This is, I think, it's a very popular method. I think you learned this. You learned this method, raise your hand if you learned this method. Or in this text, I recommend to calculate the principal stress by this determinant. This is a very simple, beautiful equation to find the principal stress. This is, you know, find the maximum or minimum of a function, yeah, this equation. So from starting this equation, this objective to find the maximum minimum. But by this method, it is very difficult to find the angle for the maximum principal stress or minimum principal to tell the difference of a little bit complicated. In this case, it is very simple to find here, you know, we start in the definition of principal stress not by the stress of maximum minimum. Okay? So forget that principal stress is the maximum or minimum. Forget this property. We start from the principal stress is normal stress, where we don't have shear stress, no shear stress exists. Okay? Here, we imagine some pen here, and if we don't have shear stress on this pen, this is the principal stress. So in this case, in this figure, I write here this normal stress, shear stress, and normal stress, shear stress, shear stress. But changing this angle of this plane, BC, we always can find some plane where the tau, you know, shear stress disappears. So the principal stress is the normal stress where the shear stress at the plane where the shear stress disappears. Yeah, this is a very important concept. So the writing this equation, you know, the BC, PXP, etc. I like this. For example, x theta. This is a, if this is a principal stress, okay? Principal stress. We have only the normal stress. We write sigma. Here we have sigma x. Here we have sigma y. And also we have tau x y. And also this is a pair of shear stress. Always, when we have a shear stress here, we have a shear stress here. So, and we assume that this length is unit, okay? So we have force in this direction is sigma, and the force in this direction is sigma x cosine theta, and force in this is tau xy cosine theta, and force in this direction is tau xy is sine theta. This is the sine is the length of this segment. and force in this direction acting in this segment is sigma y times t. Okay? So adding all this in this x component of this part is sigma 1 cosine theta. This must be here. Agree with condition C cosine theta plus tau xy times theta, and also the y direction acting on this plane is sigma sine theta, and y direction is this. And also this one, sigma y times theta. So this is the equation to determine the principal stress. This is the definition of principal stress. We have no shear stress. So in this equilibrium condition, become like this. And this in the left-hand side, we have cosine theta plus tau xy and theta equals 0, and tau xy cosine theta plus sigma y minus sigma times equals 0. Okay? This is a linear equation. If to find the cosine theta or sine theta, it's like a linear equation. If we have this kind of linear equation, to find xy, you know that this right hand side equals 0. The necessary condition to have the meaningful value of x and y is determined must be zero. So the this all these determinant of this quantity must satisfy this is the important equation to determine the principal stress. And of course, the solving this, we have the same equation for principal stress for starting from the maximum and minimum. Okay, but this is much more convenient than the very classical method of the determination of principles, because by inserting this number in this equation here, sigma 1, okay, we can determine the direction of principles very easily, cosine theta times theta, like this. Okay, this is a set of the equation. And so the important conclusion of this calculation is principal stress is a normal stress where the shear stress does not exist. Okay, this is very important. Remember this. This is the definition of the So let's write some problem. This is a solve problem. Do you have the same question here? Let me see. Here. This is a portion of problem. A solve problem. 3. Solve problem 3. Let's try this one. This is also the important problem for the twisting of when the axle subject to the torque. To find the principal stress in the twisting of a cylindrical knob like this. We twist by top T, and here at the very small element like here, we have a shear stress. Okay? This is tau xy. And in this case, we have no tensile stress, normal stress, and x and direction and transition direction. So the to determine the say this is a T. Sigma y. This is 0 and also this is 0. Minus tau. So the sigma square minus tau square equals 0. So sigma 1 is tau and sigma 2 minus tau. And direction is given in this equation. Direction is here, this is a tau, and this is zero, so the arc tangent is one, and the direction is 45 degrees, and the other direction is minus 45 degrees. Okay? So, well, this is the torsional stress rate. This is the same stress field expressed by the different stress rate. Okay, so that when we twist this kind of choke, when we twist this kind of choke, you see that this, you know, the fracture surface, you know, is. This is not exactly the 45 degree, but you know, this fracture apart from the this tensile stress, so that we have a crack along this way, this plane. So that this is another expression of the stress rate of twisting this kind of door. So that we have to have a the different eyes looking at the same phenomenon. Sometimes we have to look at this in the from the viewpoint of shear stress, and sometimes we have to look at from the viewpoint of this principal stress. Okay? And we can understand, interpret the phenomenon very clearly. Here, this calculation showed the principal stress here, and this tensile stress is sigma 1 equals tau, and another principal stress is sigma 2 equals minus tau. Okay? This is a plus 45 degree. This is a minus 45 degree. It means the principal axis. Principal axis 1 and principal axis 2 always, this direction always makes the 90 degrees. Why? Direction of two principles first. Even if we use the differentiating, you know, the source transformation equation, we have maximum stress and minimum stress. But these two stress always makes 90 degree. What is the reason?
For the same reason that you said that there was the rectangular cage with the two shear stresses were equal between each other. And now, if we have a direction with the shear stresses zero, 90 degrees direction instead of shear stresses.
Right. This is the right answer. You know, if we start from the differentiation in the, you know, the equation, okay, we can probably can calculate the two angles, but it is very difficult to verify that these two makes 90 degrees, but we started this, you know, the principal stress is normal stress acting no shear stress. Acting the plane at no shear stress. So if here, this is a plane acting, you know, the plane of principal stress 1, it means no shear stress here. This is the definition, we started from this. And other plane where we have no shear stress is no shear stress, not is we have no shear stress. So this normal stress acting on this plane is another principal stress. So the our method starting from the this definition is very useful for understanding the stress state. If we extend this to three-dimensional problem, very easy to all these principal stress act at the plane where the shear stress does not exist. So remember that the principal stress acts at the one plane and there is no shear stress on this plane. Here, this is a three-dimensional problem, 3D problem. And we have this equation, and the solution of this equation very difficult. Do you know who solved this for the first in the history of mathematics? Italian. It's the 19th century. I read this history of mathematics, very interesting. Italian first solved this, and at the 19th century there was some competition, you know, to solve the problem, and one Italian found how to solve this equation, and he made a very tricky problem which can solve only by use of this equation. No one beat him. He always wins at the game. And this is the third order equation. Fourth order equation was solved. Solution was also found by Italian. Do you know this name of this person? Ferrari, not car, you know, the model, okay? Ferrari. And in the mathematics book, the name of the person who first solved is written in Cardano. But this is not, he is not the first man who solved this equation. He stole the method solution by the very poor guy. You know, poor guys found this solution for the first time, what Cardano, you know, the negotiated very, very, you know, he's an expert of the gamble, and he, anyway, he got this solution. So in the book, it was written the Cardano solution. Anyway, this Italian solved that fourth order, and but fifth order equation, you know, the Norwegian, you know, Abel verified the fifth order cannot solve by the combination of the something plus minus or combination of some root, square root, or cubic root, or like this. Anyway, this is the problem. This is the history of mathematics. And also, when we studied the strength material in Japan, we also see the Italian names, Castigliano, Gadinod, Castigliano theorem. All the Italian names appeared in this kind of textbooks. So I respected this Italian. Yeah. Anyway, we don't need to solve this problem. If you want to solve this problem, you may open the dictionary of mathematics. It is written, the solution is written. But important thing I'd like to emphasize in this, suppose we found the solution. We have three roots here, sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3, and we can express this equation like this. And we expand again this, and this is, how do you say this? This is another expression of this equation, and this should be the same as this. So here sum of our principal three principal soils is equal to the sum of the three normal soils. They are not principal soils. So this is what do you say in English? It's invariant of stress invariant of a first order. So this is independent of the axis. Okay? This is a very strange property. Sigma x plus sigma 1 plus sigma 2 z, that equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 2 sigma 3. And this is the most important relationship. Okay? Oh, I skipped the yesterday's problem. Here, this is a problem of some bonding of pin belt. Like in old days, we in the machine factory, there was a machine operating by belt. Okay? And this is an endless belt, but it is bonded with a special bond. And no one bonded the two belt like this. Okay? It immediately is broken. So the technician, one technician had a good idea, bonded this belt by slicing in the very small angle and bonded the piece. And this problem is assuming the tensile fracture stress of bone is 1 over 400. What is the critical angle to bond successfully to this belt? This is a do you understand this problem? don't know, if we bonded in a straight like this, the strength of the, this bond is 1/40 of the strength of this part. This is the strength. Okay? Fracture strength. If this is about 1, it is 1/44. So this does not work very well. So we want to make a good bonding like this by slicing this. Theta. Sigma. Okay. We use this stress transformation. Sigma. C. And this angle is 1/40. We have no sigma y. This is sigma x. So this is and theta is so very small. Maybe this is the bond. So the must be less than on force. So the theta must be less than 1/20. So this is 1/20 approximately. This, if we slice the bond very in an inclined small angle like the ending bond, this bonding work very well. This is a very simple example of stress transformation. I proposed to the steel company in the steel company there is a rolling line, and you may know that there is a coil, and the coil is annealed in the big furnace in the line of the steel making steel company. There is a furnace, and this steel plate go and then they go pass in the annealing furnace continuously. But if this coil of the plate, or maybe this width, is used up, we have to stop this line to replace the new coil. To avoid this, there is a pulley here, over here, to adjust, adjust this length to give the time to replace the new coil. But we have to weld it to the former coil and the next coil. And here, this coil, after welding, sometimes breaks in this line. So I propose to welding the model. They used to weld the plate like this, weld very thin sheet, and they sometimes in this line stopped by. Due to the bad welding, like this. So I propose to weld this way. and the trouble should decrease. I gave this to one engineer in the Japanese company, and I think they applied a patent for this. I don't know. He could make money. I don't know. But very simple idea come from the properties of constant of stress transformation. And ending stress concept of stress, I understand. Please make a note that here I showed the portion of program here, how, okay? In this case, in the solid cylinder, tau is expressed by this equation, okay? This is the calculation by the strength of material. And if we twist in the tube line, a very thin, and P, we twist this this is in this case, this is D. D is the diameter of average diameter. D. T is very thin compared to the diameter. In this case, tau shear stress is almost uniform in the thick. Here we have the shear stress distribution, the maximum at the surface, but the zero at the center. Okay? But here the tau equal, let's see, this is tau pi dt is the area of this section. Okay? This is the area. And d over t. Radius. This is the twisting moment, tau. So the tau equal pi d squared. Okay. This is the shear stress in this when we twist the thin tube by T, twisting moment T, okay? The reason why I am giving this information to you is this is a little bit related to the problem of the competition, okay? So, and also you may learn from the by the this is the cylinder container with very thin thickness T, subjecting to the internal pressure P. Okay? Here, we have the, you know, this is the side view of the container. And this is this is the axial stress, maybe sigma x or sigma y. Here, the, I think the sigma x is in this case. Let me see that this is IDT. IDT is the area. And P. No. Sigma x or sigma x is sigma x is and sigma y. Also the very popular important right? Okay. P is acting in this this area. Yes, circular area P, and this is equivalent to the section area times sigma x. So, okay. And sigma y is calculated by the equilibrium condition of the here sigma x, sigma y, and here. We have P, so the total resultant force in the y direction is PD equal sigma y times 2P for the P over 2P. So, make a note of this solution. This is very useful when you use. Do you have any question on this on the chapter of stress? Okay. If you don't have a question, I think it's Stefano. Do you think it's better to have a short break?
I don't know. It depends on the audience.
Yes. How long?
15 minutes.
15 minutes, okay. 15 minutes.